You don't have to be a data analyst to experience the potential of Microsoft Excel errors blocking access to a file. Whether you've received a file from a colleague or downloaded a personal budget template from the internet, Excel has some built-in security features that you may need to overcome. And sometimes it's not Excel's precautionary measures causing the trouble. You may have a file that's damaged or corrupted in some way. If that's the case, you've probably seen this message pop up when opening a file. If it's the first time you've seen this error, don't worry too much. Usually the solution to fix this problem is a quick fix that you can accomplish in a few simple steps. Before I show you some methods to get around this hurdle, let's talk about the most likely cause of your delay. In my experience, the most common reason you're getting the invalid extension error is that you've received a file saved in a format that is not compatible with your version of Excel. This is generally an easy fix and one that I'll show you. The second source of your dilemma might be that you don't have permission to view the data. Whatever the reason, this too is easy enough to work through. Lastly, your workbook could have been damaged at some point. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean it has a virus, although it could, but the corrupted file could have been triggered by file system errors, faulty Excel add-ins, or previous unexpected and harmful computer shutdown. Or maybe the problem is none of these. Either way, you'll have to perform a bit of trial and error to see what works. So let me teach you a few of the more successful tricks to get your file up and running. The very first thing you want to do to troubleshoot your invalid file issue is to navigate to the folder location it's saved to. Mine is saved right to the desktop, but yours could be the Documents or Downloads folder. Go ahead and right-click the file and select Properties. What you should see is the type of file ending in extension .xlsx, which is the current Microsoft Excel format. This specific file is saved with an older version of .xls, and I'll show you how to change that in a moment. But I also want you to take note of what application is used to open the file. The default should say Excel. If it's not listed as Excel, click the Change button and update the setting. Hit OK to apply your changes. Furthermore, if you save the file directly from an external source, you should see a section at the bottom of the Properties window on the General tab that doesn't exist for your original documents. Under Attributes, there is a security label indicating that the file's source is from another computer. Just make sure that the Unblock checkbox is not checked. Let's go back to the file saved in the older format. What we want to do is update the extension to the currently preferred .xlsx. To do this, we need to allow Windows to display each file extension, at least temporarily. The simplest way is to open your search bar and search File Explorer Settings. This opens the Developer Settings where you'll look under the File Explorer tab and toggle on Show File Extensions. Close your window and go back to the file location. You can click on the file name and change the extension or use the Properties window instead. Just add the extra X at the end of the file extension and click OK. If you've tried these methods and you're still getting an error message from an external source document, you'll next want to update the permissions of the file. Right-click and open the Properties again. Underneath the Security tab, select the Advanced button toward the bottom. Next, choose Add and click the link to select a principal. You could search for a specific principal, but if this isn't a shared computer, just type everyone and click Check Names. You shouldn't get any errors, so hit OK. Now make sure the type field shows allow, and then check the permissions for full control. Click OK, then OK again. Highlight the group for everyone to verify the permissions. If all looks good, click OK. Another good troubleshooting trick is to check your Excel settings. Open up Excel and select Options at the bottom. When the window appears, choose the Save tab and make sure the save format is set to a .xlsx extension before hitting OK. In addition, you could try to go to the Trust Center settings and uncheck the three boxes enabled for Protected View. Lastly, if the file has any previous versions available, you could restore them by going to the Info section under the File tab of your document, and under Manage Workbook, recover an unsaved version. If none of these options have made a difference, or if the Info tab was grayed out making previous versions unavailable, there could be something more serious going on. If that's the case, there are two last recommendations I have for you. The first is try to open the file in safe mode. To do this, open your Run app and in the text field type Excel /safe and hit Enter. Excel will open in safe mode, and from here you can try to open the file from its folder. The second option is to open the Excel app and under File, choose Open. Browse for the file folder location of your document and highlight the file. Next to the Open button is a drop-down arrow. Click it and select Open and Repair. Now cross your fingers and hope the file can be fixed.
If none of these methods work for you, I'd recommend checking the Microsoft support forum, as it's unlikely you're the first to experience this. But I'm willing to bet one of the solutions I showed you will work. At least it does most of the time. If it did work for you and you've gotten some value from this video, hit that like button and consider subscribing. If you're having any other problems I didn't discuss, drop them in the comments and I'll see if I can come up with a resolution for you. See you next time.